Hello guys, it's our third lesson, Turkish A1 level, and the theme is nerelisin. It means where are you from? In this part, we use the names of the cities or countries, and at the end, we add this suffix, lı, li, lulu. The question is, which one I will use? Well, if the last vowel in the word is for example, in the suffix you can use a or ı. If it is ending with e, you can use only e or i in the suffix. You see the table and let's see how we do it. For example, nerelisin, as you see, it is ending with e in the question, and after the e, we have to use i. Why? Because lı, li, lulu, we can't use le. We have to use li only. So nerelisin, and in the answer, it's ending with a, so after a, I have to use ı in the suffix. Ankaralıyım. And the others also follow this harmony because in Turkish it's called büyük sesli uyumu. Büyük ünlü uyumu, we say. Okay. For example, let's see the next one. İstanbul. İstanbul, as you see, is ending with u. Let's check the table. After the u, we use u in the suffix. So, İstanbullu. And it means I am İstanbulluyum. İstanbulluyum. Ordu is another city. Look, Ordu is ending with u. So, Orduluyum. İzmir is ending with i. İzmirliyim. As you see, after i, we use i in the suffix. İzmirliyim, Kazakistanlıyım. Amerikalı, İtalyalı, New Yorklu, İstanbullu, İzmirli. Okay, let's study the other one. Ben Ankaralıyım. It means I am from Ankara. In this part, the question is always, sen nerelisin? If for example, if you are speaking with a bigger guy, you have to say, siz nerelisiniz? Where are you from? Siz nerelisiniz? Ben Ankaralıyım. I am from Ankara. Sen Ankaralısın. You are from Ankara. O Ankaralı. He is from Ankara. Biz Ankaralıyız. We are from Ankara. Siz Ankaralısınız. You are from Ankara. Onlar Ankaralılar. They are from Ankara. Ben is means I. In this form, for example, if somebody says Ankaralıyım, it is the same with ben Ankaralıyım. İm gives the meaning of ben. For example, in the second one, you don't have to use sen always. You can say Ankaralısın. It means you are from Ankara. In the third one, we don't use person suffix. Biz Ankaralıyız. Or you can just say Ankaralıyız. Siz Ankaralısınız. You are from Ankara. Onlar Ankaralılar. They are from Ankara. Okay, let's study with Hindistan. Hindistan is the country name, India. It is ending with a, so I have to use ı in the suffix. Can you see that? Ankaralı, excuse me, Hindistanlıyım. And the rule is going on. The harmony is going on. Hindistan, you are from India. Hindistan, listen. The form is always same. Turkish is very, very, very nice language. It's very easy if you know the rules, guys. You know, a. It is ending with a, so I learned it. I have to use ı. Hindistanlıyız. We are from India. Then in the suffix, I have to use ı, and the other one must be also ı. Hindistanlısınız. You are from. For plural, we use Hindistanlısınız. Hindistanlısınız. Okay, let's do the last one. Hindistanlılar, they are from India. Hindistanlılar. As you see, guys, the table never changes. Hindistanlı, if it is ending with ı, we can use ı or a in the suffix. As you see, it obeys the rule. A is also the other one that obeys the rule. Tunus, Tunusluyum, Tunuslusun, Tunuslu, Tunusluyuz, Tunuslusunuz, Tunuslular. Peki, let's learn another one. Hawaii. In here, for example, there's A and E. We have to check always the last one. Hawaii'liyim. We have to use the last one, okay? Hawaii'liyim. Hawaii'lisin. Hawaii'li. Hawaii'liyiz. Hawaii'lisiniz. Hawaii'liler. Okay. No. Sen ne istiyorsun? It is, I think, very important in Turkish. People will ask you these questions. Sen ne istiyorsun? Excuse me. Sen ne istiyorsun? What do you want? Ne is what? Okay. Sen ne istiyorsun? Instead of this ne, you have to find an object that you want. And you will put the subject and the verb. Ben blah blah istiyorum, for example. You can put here any noun, guys. Ben telefon istiyorum. Ben telefon istiyorum. Ben baklava istiyorum. Ben baklava istiyorum. Telefon is noun. Infinitive form. Baklava is also another noun. If you need a noun, you will just put here. Ben kitap istiyorum. I want a book. Ben BMW istiyorum. I want a BMW. Okay. As you see, it is very easy. But sometimes you need a verb. And this, sen ne yapmak? Yapmak istiyorsun. What do you want to do? If the question is this one, it is also very easy, guys. As you see, yap is verb. So we add mak make after the verb. So ben okumak istiyorum. I want to read. Ben yürümek istiyorum. I want to walk. Ben oturmak istiyorum. I want to sit. Ben konuşmak istiyorum. I want to speak. Ben uyumak istiyorum. I want to sleep. Ben anlamak istiyorum. I want to understand. Ben öğrenmek istiyorum. I want to learn. Ben dinlenmek istiyorum. I want to rest. Ben yüzmek istiyorum. I want to swim. I want to swim. Ben tanışmak istiyorum. I want to know or I want to meet with her. Now, let's see our table is working or not. As you see, U is at the end of the word and the next one can be U or A. As you see, it obeys the rule. In here, for example, the word is ending with U, so we put A after the verb, okay? Oturmak. This one is ending with U, so I have to use mak again because it has only two variant, mak or mek. If it is ending with A, I, O, U, we use mak. I can write it for you. If the word is ending with A, O, U, you can use just mak. But if it is ending with, for example, E, I, Ö, Ü, you have to use mek form. For example, yüzmek. For example, öğrenmek. For example, dinlenmek. Just check the last vowel place in your verb. Okay. In English, how can we say it? It is ing form. I want reading. I want swimming, for example. Okay. So it is very easy. By learning this, you can make many, many good sentences, guys. Thanks a lot for listening to me. See you the next lesson. Bye.